Welcome back. Inflation is often a forgotten element in planning for retirement, and it can have a big impact on retirees who often live on a fixed income. While retirees no longer have to feed a family or save for a child's high-priced college education, they still have to cover food, housing costs, and medical bills. Here to talk about inflation, my guest, Richard Warner. Richard, thanks for joining us. So how do you factor inflation into a typical retirement plan?
Well, inflation is a big deal in retirement. And in my practice, when I sit down and talk to folks, I see this not being addressed. And the big factor is people are living so much longer, so it gives time for inflation to rear its ugly head. So very specifically, they have to plan for it. They've got to figure out where they are and project that out into the future, maybe a 20-year, 30-year time frame.
So now, what strategies can investors use to offset the effects of inflation on their planning?
Well, there's a few things they can do. Number one, they got to plan. Some of that begins with their Social Security strategy, as you mentioned, Scott. Deferring Social Security can be a benefit for them in that. They also have to make sure in their asset allocation and what they're investing in that they're keeping ahead of inflation with the returns they're getting. So things that get a fixed interest rate in the bank, for example, they don't tend to keep up with, at least historically, don't tend to keep up with inflation. So they've got to plan and prepare for that.
Well, inflation, you know, has been low for a number of years, but that really can't last, can it?
No, and we're seeing it start to turn. Over the last 10 years, it's been somewhere between 1.5% to 2% inflation, which is significantly lower than historically. If you track the CPA, it's over 3%. And I really believe, and economists really believe, that over the next 10, 20 years, we're going to see inflation for lots of different reasons. Number one, those interest rates are starting to turn back around again, and that's also going to drive the cost of goods and services up.
All right, Richard, thanks again.
Thanks, Scott, for having me.
Richard Warner has been my guest, and you're watching Retirement News Online.